Hello, welcome to another exciting episode of Hot Tracks. I'm Nick Van Zanten.
And I'm JB West.
Especially what a good day we had last week Friday. Hudsonville won, beating Northview 17-7. How did Jenison do?
Demolished. They're still in the playoffs, I could tell you right now. But they lost almost quite a heartbreaker to Rockford.
So they lost to Rockford.
Yeah. Quite a heartbreaker. But they're still in the playoffs.
Yeah, Hudsonville's in the playoffs now, too. Go Eagles.
Uh-huh.
And also, marching band competition, November 2nd on Saturday at the Pontiac Silverdome.
And I'm sure you're going to cover it.
Actually, no, it's not going to be covered. It's going to be watched.
Oh, nice.
But let's proceed on with what we have today in music.
Okay.
This is the CD Sugarine by a local band doing good called 19 Wheels. I met the drummer of this band, Rob Dickey. The track we're going to be rate is Good Enough.
Okay, proceeding on here, I'll be doing the latest hit. Well, it's not a latest, but it's an oldie but goodie from Def Leppard. I got this old album right here called Europhoria, and the song I'll be doing is Promises.
It could be called Euphoria.
Euphoria, thank you. Because the latest album, which I don't have yet, is 10. That's the latest from Def Leppard, and the latest hit sure is still, what, Now?
You know, I think a latest CD or latest hit would be called A New Thing.
A New Thing?
Probably, that's what I hear.
Okay.
And now we come to Tal Bachman. This guy is the son of Randy Bachman of the Bachman-Turner Overdrive and the Guess Who. We're going to be rating a classic by Tal Bachman that's heard on I-96 called She's So High.
Okay, this is the last album that the Police did, and I thought I'd do this hit, Every Breath You Take, because this song was also remade when they did the dedication to the Notorious B.I.G.
Actually, that was remade by Puff Daddy, who is now P. Diddy.
Right. But this is the hit that the Police did first, and you'll see what I mean later on.
All right. Then we come to Journey's Greatest Hits, back when Steve Perry was with them. We're going to be writing the song Wheel in the Sky.
That'd be good. So we get to hear the latest, the late, great Steve Perry.
Exactly.
That's nice. All right, speaking of late greats, I have the Greatest Hits album from INXS. And we'll be doing a hit, Suicide Blonde. And this is the album that was dedicated to the late, great Michael Hutchence, former lead singer of INXS.
All right.
And of course, let's not forget, later on, we'll have another mystery CD, and we're going to recap.
That's right. And so, let's take it away.
Okay.
Hearing the song, Good Enough by 19 Wheels.
How'd we wind up here? Who would build a sandbox on a fault line? I can taste the dirt when I'm by myself. I can dig for days with just your help.
Will you come along? I think it's big enough.
That was the song Good Enough by 19 Wheels. I've seen 19 Wheels in concert at Celebration on the Grand. I've also met Rob Dickey as well. He came here to Hudsonville High School for a drum set clinic in our ensemble room right by the band room. It was a good clinic. First time I've seen Rob Dickey. But when I saw the band, that was the second time I've seen Rob Dickey. The concert at Celebration on the Grand was excellent. I like the way they harmonized this song. So I give this song 5 stars.
Five stars as well. Question. Do you think, first off, what's next for 19 Wheels now?
Well, I think they just probably had their last concert at the Intersection. I gotta keep track on that, on what they're up to right now on the website.
Which one is that? WGRD.com?
No, that is 19wheels.com.
19wheels.com.
Yeah.
So they may be performing again somewhere in a city near you.
Probably. I wouldn't know for sure. It depends on what's next for them, but I do have a subscription to a newsletter that talks about the band only and the new stuff they do.
Uh-huh. Good hit. And that was good enough for us. Okay. An oldie but goodie as we move on. This is from Def Leppard's latest album, Euphoria. Thank you. Trying to get the E out perfectly on that one. But the song we're going to be rating is was from the latest hit, Promises. And you'll find this song pretty interesting. So here it is. That was Promises from Def Leppard. In the lyrics, there goes, I won't make promises that I can't keep. Now, if I were to do a hit like that, I should change the lyrics, goes, I will make promises that I can keep. But that one makes the good hit. So, anyway, 5 stars on that one.
Same here. That is a good hit. But exactly. For those of you who don't know this, but most of you know this, the drummer for Def Leppard, Rick Allen, only has one arm because his left arm is missing. He lost it in a fatal car crash. And the seatbelt is what made him lose his arm. It must have wrapped around him or it must have cut through. And he thought to himself, uh-oh, this shouldn't be happening, and I'm a drummer. So he's only got one arm.
Yeah, I was wondering whatever happened to him. I mean, it was inconclusive for me. I don't know if you've seen the Hysteria of the Def Leppard story.
Well, I've seen Behind the Music of Def Leppard on VH1, and it told the exact story on how Rick Allen lost his arm.
Uh-huh. So, 5 stars for you on the Promises, right?
Right, because I love the way how they harmonize that.
Okay, continuing on.
All right, now we come to Tal Bachman. He is the son of Randy Bachman, and Randy Bachman was in the Guess Who in the Bachman-Turner Overdrive. And this song is called She's So High, and it plays on I-96. It is a good song. I love it.
Okay.
She's blood, flesh, and bone. Now tubs of silicone. She's touch, smell, sight, taste, and sound. But somehow I can't believe that anything should happen. I know where I belong, and nothing's gonna happen. So high above me, she's so low.
Now we just heard the song She's So High by Tal Bachman. That is a good song. That is played on I-96. Good song. I give that 5 stars.
The hit sounds good. I've seen the video. This one lady comes in. I think when they mentioned in the second chorus, in the second, you know, She's So High, like Cleopatra, Joan of Arc. I wonder if that lady was like a combination of both what the singer was just singing, Cleopatra and Joan of Arc.
I don't know about that for sure. But I have not seen the video, but I've heard the song many times.
But that's what makes it so good.
Exactly, especially since that guy's the son of Randy Bachman.
Uh-huh. It's good. 5 stars.
All right.
I'll do the same. All right. Now we come to what seems to be the last album that the Police have made. The album is Synchronicity.
Or it could be Synchronicity.
Thank you. But the hit that we're going to do is Every Breath You Take. And why they did this song is they first did the original, which we're going to hear in a moment, but they also redid this hit.
Actually,
in honor of the Notorious B.I.G.
Actually, Puff Daddy is the one that remade the hit.
Puff Daddy is what's the one who remade the hit.
Yeah, not the Police.
Not the Police, but it was sent out to the Notorious B.I.G.
By Puff Daddy.
By Puff Daddy. But anyway, let's hear the original Every Breath You Take from the Police. We just heard the Police and Every Breath You Take. Like I said, Puff, as Nick said, Puff Daddy redid the hit as in honor of the Notorious B.I.G. I still like the original. As a matter of fact, Sting, who's still on solo, still does that hit. And you will find that hit on his latest album, All This Time, the greatest work he did. It was performed on a live concert.
Yeah, it's probably his new one.
Yeah. The song, I give it 5 stars.
I give it 5 stars, too, because I've been a huge Police fan for quite a while. But I have never seen them in concert, but I sure would like to see Sting in concert sometime, because I am a Sting fan.
Yeah, get a listen to that hit, Every Breath You Take. It's supposed to be real good.
Yeah. One of my other favorite songs that the Police ever did was King of Pain.
King of Pain.
I really love the beginning to King of Pain.
Oh, yeah. I have that.
It's right on that CD, too.
Yeah. Nice. All right.
Next one. We're going to be writing Wheelin' the Sky by Journey. I love this song, especially when I first heard it at Galleon's. This is an excellent song, so let's play it.
Okay.
On a long shot.
All right, that was Wheel in the Sky by Journey. That is a good song. It's on their greatest hits. This is actually when Steve Perry was with them. I give that song 5 stars. We didn't hear much of the song. All we just heard was part of the first verse and the beginning, but we didn't hear the chorus.
Yeah, Wheel in the Sky keeps on turning. Don't know where I'll be tomorrow.
That is right. No one knows where they'll be tomorrow except the students here at Hudsonville High School know they'll be here tomorrow.
Right. Right. I'll give that song 5 stars because there's a combination, like when we did Journey's Arrival. Steve Algeri and Steve Perry. They both sound like the same. They both sound like they have the same voice.
Yeah, they do. Yeah, they do.
Yes. But if I had to choose, I would probably still adore the late, great Steve Perry.
Well, Steve Perry is not dead. He only has hip problems.
Yeah, hip problems. But that one makes him still a legend.
True.
All right. Speaking of legends, I come now to this hit from INXS. INXS, the greatest hits. This album went out and dedicated to the late, great Stephen Hutchins. And the hit we're going to do is Suicide Blonde. Good hit. I recognized, liked it myself. So here it is. Okay, there you go. INXS, the greatest hits. The hit Suicide Blonde. Like I said, this album went out to the late, great Stephen Hutchins, a terrific frontman for INXS. And he is still forever gratefully missed. But the song did pretty well, and I liked it. Anyone likes INXS is a great fan. As a matter of fact, they got another CD out called The Best of INXS. Check it out. The song, 5 stars.
Well, exactly. Whatever happened to Stephen Hutchins? What did he die of?
I have no idea.
Huh. You had no idea what
I probably, I might guess. What was that? From our director. Thank you.
All right.
Say it, because they can't hear me.
I heard that he died of a drug overdose.
All right, well, you never knew what Jeff Porcaro died of. Neither do I, but there was an article in Modern Drummer about that he will be forever missed.
Uh-huh.
But that song was good, somewhere in between good and excellent.
Uh-huh.
But I'll just give it 4.5.
4.5, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, well, keep your ears open. I think coming up next, we got ourselves our mystery CD. We don't know what it is, but I'm sure we'll play it for you when we come back.
That's exactly right. So just be sure, don't you dare miss out on the mystery song on what it is. We will be right back after these messages.
Keep it here. You're on Hot Tracks.
If you want to stay informed of what's happening in your community, then your Grand Valley Advance newspaper is what you've been looking for. This weekly newspaper is packed full of area news stories, sports, syndicated columns, recipes, classified ads, announcements, display advertisements, coupons, and of course, garage sales in the community. Your courteous delivery person cheerfully brings your Grand Valley newspaper every Tuesday, and WCET would like to thank the Grand Valley Advance for their support through the years. The Grand Valley Advance is your weekly community newspaper.
Hi, I'm Larry Treese, president of Healthcare Associates and Community Caregivers. Many of you know someone who may need extra help to stay at home, whether it's bathing, medications, meal prep, personal care, or even transportation. We can assist you with living at home. Call us at 531-9973 for information on our home care services. Some services for home care are covered by Medicare.
All right, now we're back on Hot Tracks. And today we have a mystery song. JB and I do not know what it is, but we are going to find out. But we have to hear it, see if we like it or not.
And then if we do like it, we'll rate the hit by the number of stars.
Exactly.
Okay, so.
Let's hear the mystery song.
Okay, here it is.
All right, we just heard the mystery song.
Mm-hmm.
And this group that we just heard is a punk rock group. And we don't know who the artist is, but there could have been some swear words, so might have to lower it to 2.5 stars for me.
Yeah, I mean, I'll agree with you on this one, because I think you were right, because when we did Dirty White Boy from Foreigner, we lowered the level to just, what, 2 stars, even?
Yeah.
Even?
Yeah.
Because you were right, because it did have a swear word, because the second verse did have a swear word. And I agree with this, Sid, because it rocks out okay. I mean, it's good music. People are probably just, you know, jamming in their cars, you know, doing heavy metal like that, so.
Yeah, but if it's little kids that are listening to it in their cars, and if their parents are with them, their parents would disapprove.
Yeah, yeah.
Why don't we hear from our director who it is?
Okay.
The song is The Bad by Pantera.
The Bad by Pantera. Okay, there you go.
The Badge by
The
Pantera.
Badge. Okay. The Badge by Pantera.
The Crow CD.
The Crow? The first one or the second one?
The first movie.
The first movie. Yes, I'll agree with you. 2 stars.
Well, except my friend Adam Chandler is a big Pantera fan. So is Rex Stilwell and Tony Mosher and other guys who I know here at Hudsonville High School who are into punk rock. They probably are not going to be very happy about what I've rated the Pantera song, but they're going to have to get used to disappointment.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, anyone who's a big fan of Pantera, listen very closely to the lyrics.
Exactly. But Adam Chandler suggested to me that we ought to have his band Halo on the show. And Halo also has Tony Mosher and Rex Stilwell. They will be releasing a demo CD pretty soon.
That'd be good. That'd be good. Maybe some good, clean lyrics.
I wouldn't know about that. I've seen Halo in concert at... I've seen Halo in concert at Skeletones. That was when they had 4 members.
Okay.
And so what really happened is... That was when Halo had 4 members. Before they even had a keyboard player, there's only one song that they only had a swear word on, and it said the word BS. But there's one song that, the exact day when I seen Halo in concert, they did a song that they just wrote on the very same day of the gig called Bringing Down the Sun. If we hear Bringing Down the Sun, we can rate it, but we don't have the CD.
Okay, well, we got to recap.
Yeah, we do. We just We started out with 19 Wheels, Sugarine, rated the song Good Enough. And so that song, JB and I both gave that 5 stars.
Okay, I come now to Def Leppard's Promises. It's an oldie but goodie. Help me out again, Nick.
Euphoria.
Euphoria, thank you. The song Promises. Good hit. Me and Nick, we gave that 5 stars.
All right, next one. She's So High by Tal Bachman. This guy's the son of Randy Bachman, like I've mentioned on the show. So JB and I both gave the song She's So High 5 stars.
Okay, The Police. Synchronous City and the hit Every Breath You Take. I like the original. So I gave that 5 stars, but Nick, did you give that song also 5 stars as well?
Yeah, I did.
Okay, so it's an even. Just had to make sure.
All right.
Hope you guys are keeping score.
Yep. Now we come to Wheel in the Sky by Journey. JB and I both gave that 5 stars.
Okay. To the greatest legends, such as Steve Perry, to the late great Stephen Hutchins of NXS, we did Suicide Blonde. Good hit. I gave it 5 stars.
I gave it 4.5.
So it was a huge difference. Well, not so very huge.
Yeah, but I still gave it a good rating, even though I gave it 4.5.
Mm-hmm. Okay, and now our mystery CD, I think if we can take a look. Nick, why don't you go ahead and tell about the album, about The Crow?
Well,
it was our mystery CD.
Yeah, exactly. I might have to hold the CD cover.
Okay, go ahead.
Well, this is The Crow. This is a movie soundtrack. And what we heard is a song by Pantera, and the song was called The Badge. JB and I both gave that 2 stars because Pantera is a punk rock band and there could have been some swear words in the song.
Yeah, so once again, check the lyrics. Some of them may not be quite as good as I thought.
Exactly, and this movie is also rated R.
Yeah.
I've never seen the movie.
Oh yeah, Brandon Lee, right? His last movie. Well, speaking of,
What was that?
Brandon Lee died in that movie.
Brandon Lee died in that movie, so that's why he played the role as The Crow.
Ah.
All right. Well, with that, there goes episode 6 of Hot Tracks for you.
That's right. Hope you've had a good time watching this. And stay tuned in for next week as when we rate the music again and do trivia from the 50s.
And plus, let's not forget, we'll have another mystery CD.
That's right.
Who knows? It may be something we don't know.
All right. Well, till then, hope you've had an excellent time. Until then, JB and I will see you next time once when we rate the music on Hot Tracks.
So long.